Hello, and welcome to a new video. I'm Jamila, and today is February 13th, so tomorrow is Valentine's Day. And I thought it would be timely to talk about self-love or self-care. And yeah, that's what I'm going to do in this video. So stay tuned. I guess I'm going to give examples of what self-love or self-care is to me. And yeah, at the end of this video, I hope you will let me know if you do any of the same things, or if you liked it, or yeah, have anything to add that I maybe left out. So I'll just get started. The first thing on my list for self-care is kind of doing things that help you relax or feel good about yourself. And I'm not super into like beauty and things, but I'm wearing like a lip balm that I got recently, and I love to do my nails, so I'm gonna show you some nail polishes. I wanna do like a really cute Valentine's Day design, either later today or maybe I'll just wait until tomorrow. But yeah, I love pink, so it was hard to choose. I think I'm gonna use the two pink ones for my nails and the red for like a pedicure. But that makes me really happy. Like, I usually do my nails like at least once a month. And usually like a seasonal theme, so I'm excited to do that. And the next thing would be to kind of like treat yourself to things. So I bought these for myself, some tulips, and Priyata was saying, I love flowers, like they really make me happy, and you don't need to wait for someone else to buy you flowers, you can always buy them for yourself, nothing wrong with that. And these really need to go in water, but I thought like making a video was like, I don't know, more relevant. So yeah, I'm gonna put them in water when I finish this. Yeah, I love tulips. Yeah. Moving on. But yeah, this is just an example of something you can like treat yourself to. This is pretty inexpensive, like to just get flowers for yourself. But later this year, maybe in like the spring or summer, I'm gonna treat myself to a really nice trip, so yeah, hopefully I'll go. I haven't really decided where exactly. I want to go everywhere, but who doesn't? So yeah, that's like a not so expensive, inexpensive treat for myself. But yeah, moving along. The third thing that I think is super important, or like a really good example of self-care, is getting enough sleep. I think it's so easy to get like caught up in things, like, and yeah, just kind of skimp on your sleep schedule, or yeah. But I know I feel horrible when I don't have enough sleep, so yeah, get your 8 hours or however many hours your body needs. Yeah, I just think like adequate sleep is probably one of the most important things you can do. Yeah, that's all I have to say about that. The next thing, which is also pretty important, is nutrition. So no matter like what's going on in your life, I think you should always try to get plenty of water, veggies, fruit, like nuts or seeds or some kind of healthy fat. Yeah, and try to get all of your like vitamins and minerals. Whether you get that in your food or like you supplement, I think just that's like what comes to mind when I think of like taking care of yourself, like the kind of physical aspect, like nutrition. And then with that, obviously, is fitness. So I always show my like Fitbit, or I used to have a Garmin, but yeah, it died, and yeah. So for now, I'm team Fitbit. But yeah, whatever you do, if you run or bike, swim, walk, just move, I think that's really important too. I used to love badminton, but I haven't played in a while. I might do that sometime soon. But yeah, sleep, nutrition, fitness, those are all really important things to do. And I think those are really good examples of self-care. I made a little list, I'm like trying to remember. I think relationships are really important. So whether it's like a romantic relationship, family relationship, or a relationship with your friends, just like build and maintain strong relationships. A lot of people have said that like that's kind of what life is all about. So, whether you agree or not, I don't really know how I feel about that, but I guess it's probably true. Yeah, I think it's still something that's at least important. So, yeah, make sure you build and maintain relationships with people who love and respect you. Yeah, and that's all there really is to that. And it kind of starts with self-care. So, yeah, it all ties in. The other thing that isn't like a traditional self-care example would be to work on your career and just have like goals for yourself. Like, I don't know, maybe it isn't important to everyone at every age or time in their life, but I think for me, like, well, I'm going through like a career change, so it's really exciting. Yeah, just do something that you know you're gonna love and that you can work hard in, hard at, and like be really good at, and ideally be the best at. So yeah, you get a lot of enjoyment from it. So you're not really working, even though you are. If that makes sense. And with career, I would say finances. Pay attention to, yeah, your balances and make sure you're putting away money for like your future retirement and just all the fun things you want to do in life. You don't want to have to like worry that you don't have enough to, yeah, like travel or buy a house or whatever it is that you want to do with your money. Yeah. Moving along. Something that I personally love is learning new things. So I think it's, yeah, good to work your brain. I love languages especially, but I just love learning anything. So I try to get some kind of like personal development audio book or program or reading too, but not I don't do that so much these days. But definitely learn from other people. Don't let your brain rot or your mind rot, like that, yeah, isn't good for anyone. But besides that, like I did say languages, I love Memrise and like Babbel and Duolingo. I'm always using one of them. Sometimes I use like two or all three in a day, but I don't think anyone else is that obsessed. But definitely learn things, like whatever interests you. And I'm almost finished with this list. I have like two things left. So the second to last thing is hobbies or like creative outlets. So yeah, I mentioned like I like badminton and I like languages, all that kind of stuff. But recently, I started doing a puzzle. I don't. It's kind of far away. I'll just get it. Well, here is the box. Let's just see. You can see that. So this is a 1,000 piece puzzle, and I'm a good like 850 pieces into it, I would say. And here's like a bigger picture of it. Can I see that? Yeah, it's like the sky is giving me trouble. No, this is not like the most interesting thing, but I finished like the entire bottom section. But I haven't done like a good like 1,000 piece jigsaw puzzle in like a few years. So yeah. That's been really I wouldn't say challenging, but really like I guess challenging, yeah. Like but in a fun way. Like I felt like in the zone when I was like just like zipping through. So yeah, don't neglect your hobbies. Sometimes life does get busy and we need to like focus on something more important, but yeah. Always go back to it when you have time. And the very last thing on the list, or my list anyway, is to volunteer or like do something for someone besides you, like yourself. So yeah, maybe it is volunteering, maybe it's donating time or things you don't really need to someone who maybe does. I'm like trying to declutter my closet, but it's like, a little slow. But yeah, I'll just run through like each of the things really quickly. But that's it, yeah. So taking care of yourself, like, yeah, it might be like getting dressed up or, yeah, like I actually treated myself to this necklace too. Yeah, treating yourself to things, taking care of yourself, how, like, and how you look, if that's important to you. Getting enough sleep, enough exercise, healthy foods, maintaining your close relationships, yeah, building your career or moving forward, like getting promotions if, yeah, if there's something you want to advance in. And if you're a student, like focusing on your education so that you'll be able and ready to focus on your career a little bit later. Hobbies, creative outlets, which is kind of the same. Learning new things, like, or lifelong learning. I'm a big fan of that. I'm a strong believer. And the last one was, like, helping other people or doing something that doesn't necessarily benefit you. But, that's it for my list of, I'm not sure how many, maybe it was 10 or 8 or 9, something like that. But that's it for my list of examples of self-care. Yeah. It's probably really hard to do all of them in like a given day or week or something, but as long as you feel good and you're getting most of those things done for yourself, I think you're on the right track. And yeah, don't stress. Be kind to yourself and to others, and happy Valentine's Day tomorrow. Bye.